Hi, welcome to the Reclaim Your channel, and today we talk about file metadata. Metadata is a description of the file which is not a part of the file. Metadata usually includes file name, parent directory, date and time of file creation, access rights, file owner, and other. Additionally, the location of file content on a disk is also metadata, although this information is often considered separately. What metadata and how it is stored is determined by a file system. For example, a file can have one or several names. As for date and time, typically the standard set includes the time of creation, the last modification, and the last read. In different file systems, these dates are stored with different accuracy and have different allowed ranges. For example, some file systems do not track the date of the last access, although they have fields for this information in their metadata. For example, NTFS does so with the default settings. In some file systems, the time of the last access and the time of file deletion are stored in metadata as well. A file system often needs to find and change metadata quickly. Metadata can be stored in tables. However, it can be rather difficult to find the needed record in the table, since a file system should go through the entire table. Slow search. Another structure for metadata is B-tree. B-trees are used for metadata which should be found quickly. Fast search. As for the inner organization, tables are significantly simpler than B-trees. Tables and B-trees can be used in different proportions. For example, FAT uses only tables and so does not work well with directories having the large number of files. NTFS uses tables for metadata and B-trees for directories to find files quickly. XFS uses small tables for metadata and B-trees to find the needed table. BTRFS and HFS use B-trees and do not use tables at all. However, in all file systems there is a record storing metadata. No matter how the search for this record is organized and what pointers to this record exist. And if this record is lost, it is impossible to recover metadata. File system recovery consists in searching for all possible metadata pieces and recreating cross-references between them. Tables usually store metadata of same kind. For example, inodes are stored in one table, file names are stored in other table. Localized failure can damage the entire table, thus destroying all metadata of the same type. For example, it may happen that inodes are intact while file names are destroyed. In this case, files lose their file names. B-trees, due to sorting specifics, store all metadata of a particular file in one place. B-trees consists of blocks of two types. Blocks storing pointers to other blocks and blocks storing actual metadata. Typically, it is pretty easy to find blocks just by scanning a disk. Blocks with pointers are useless in data recovery because blocks with metadata can be found without them. Now let's talk about file deletion. File systems storing metadata in tables behave more predictably than those using B-trees. In some file systems, for example in NTFS, when a file is deleted, its record in a table is just marked as empty and no more changes are done. Thus, if no data is written to a disk, you can still undelete the file. In file systems like VMFS, when a file is deleted, its record in a table is actually zeroed, and therefore it is impossible to recover the file. However, the behavior is the same for all deletions on the same file system. Now let's talk about file deletion on B-tree file systems. If not the entire block is deleted, a file system usually rebuilds the entire block and no traces about the previous metadata exist. If the entire block is deleted, a file system can just reconstruct the tree rather than actually erasing metadata, and therefore undelete for the metadata is still possible. This is called tree rebalancing. Now let's depict how files are deleted on B-tree file systems, taking HFS as an example. A tree consists of blocks of two types: pointer blocks and leaf blocks. Metadata is stored in leaf blocks. If we zoom in, a leaf block looks like this. Metadata, free space and pointers. This leaf block stores G and H records. Now let's imagine that we need to delete G record. In this case, a file system reconstructs the entire block. And now it holds H record. Free space will be zeroed. As you can see, undelete for G record is impossible. Now let's imagine that we need to delete E, F, G and H records. In this case, a file system just deletes this pointer rather than erases these blocks. And in this case, undelete for metadata stored in these blocks is still possible. That's all about file metadata. In the next video, I will discuss FAT file system. If you like our videos, subscribe to the Reclaim Me channel. Reclaim Me team was with you. See you soon!